sushi, sashimi, and katsu. Ceviche, lomo saltado, and arroz con mariscos. These are just some of the dishes that remind us of Tokyo in Japan and Lima in Peru. So we decided to revisit the natural complementing flavors of these two cuisines in the newest Japanese-Peruvian restaurant in the city, Japonesa in Poblacion.
What a lot of people don't know is it's not a new cuisine, actually. It's nearly over 100 years old at this point. So this is actually originated in Peru over 100 years ago when I think the story is back in the day, migrant workers started flooding into Peru once they abolished slavery in the late 1800s. So we have an influx of Chinese population, Japanese population, all sorts of different Asian indigenous peoples moving into South America. And that's when the cuisine was born, right? So you have these Japanese nationals looking for a taste of home, but they have to utilize local ingredients, right, that they're finding in Peru. So it's been a fusion cuisine for a very long time, and we're just trying our best to honor that.
The secret spice in this fusion lies in traditional ingredients. Japan, with its fresh fish, mixes perfectly with the strong spices of Peru. An order of ceviche, for instance, is thinly sliced, and instead of being marinated for hours, this one would just be lightly dressed with sauce, much like how we would typically eat an assortment of sashimi with soy sauce and wasabi on the side. The same goes for this hamachi tiradito, a classic Japanese yellowtail fish with yuzu and garlic chimichurri sauce.
So when you see a blend of those two cuisines, you're going to see lots of raw food, lots of raw fish, and you're going to have them accompanied by some spice and some sour notes from the citrus fruits. But of course, we're in the Philippines where not so many people can handle those intense flavors, especially the spice. So we tone ours down just a bit so that we don't set people's mouths on fire here.
Japonesa also got creative by adding Peruvian touches to another classic Japanese dish, maki rolls. A must-try is their signature La Japonesa, a crispy and delicious roll of deep-fried sushi rice topped with spicy tuna and a slice of green chili. Their take on a Japanese katsu is lengua katsu, a first in the city. Lengua, or beef tongue, a popular meat in Peru, is, as the name suggests, battered and deep fried to perfection, making every bite crispy and tender. It's served with creamy potatoes and smothered with delectable lengua gravy. They also serve lomo saltado, a traditional Peruvian dish with marinated beef strips with onions and tomatoes in a rich sauce. Their anticuchos de lomo reminds us of that. Only this one is skewered and brushed with a special house-blended sauce and grilled, guaranteeing a burst of umami in every bite. Seasonal vegetables, chicken skin, and king oyster mushrooms are also just some of their yakitori selections. At night, Japonesa is a hotspot for a diverse selection of drinks. A must-try is the White Rabbit, made with Japanese whiskey and Manzino vermouth.
And then what we do is we put it into a little jar and we funnel in smoke from apple wood that we burn here in the, behind the bar. So you get this super smoky whiskey that tastes like your childhood, like white rabbit candy. And when it comes to the table, you know, the smoke is inside the drink, you swirl it around, and when you knock it back, it takes you back to your childhood in a weird way, because now you're getting drunk too.
At the end of the day, regardless of what combinations of flavors go in the dish, the important thing is that it tastes good and satisfies our cravings. Who love sushi and fragrant spices will not find it difficult to fall in love with the Japanese-Peruvian fusion. The familiar decadent flavors all but guarantee it.